Welcome to our Mystery Sleep Stories channel, your sanctuary for meditation and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this quest for deep sleep. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our mystery bedtime stories. So, let the tale begin. The Quest for the Last Corsair. Chapter 1. The Vanishing Corsair. In the bustling port of Tortuga, where pirates and privateers mingled freely, the story of Captain Rafael Serrano's disappearance was on everyone's lips. Known as the Jaguar of the Seas, Serrano was a corsair whose daring exploits had become legendary. His sudden vanishing had left a void in the pirate world, and many speculated about his fate. The news of a hidden treasure known as the Corsair's Gold, allegedly linked to Serrano, ignited a fervor among the pirates. It was said to be a hoard of unimaginable wealth, accumulated from countless raids, and hidden in a secret location known only to Serrano. Among those drawn to this tale was Captain Isabela Rivera, a pirate renowned for her cunning and bravery. She had crossed swords with the navies of multiple empires and had emerged victorious each time. Her first mate, Luis Martinez, was equally formidable, known for his knowledge of ancient lore and sailing skills. Assembling a crew of the most skilled and loyal pirates, Isabela planned to embark on a quest to uncover the truth behind Serrano's disappearance and locate the Corsair's Gold. The crew gathered in the dimly lit back room of the Drunken Kraken, a tavern frequented by sailors and outlaws. There, Isabela unveiled an ancient, weathered map, a mysterious chart that she believed held the key to finding Serrano's treasure. The map was a tapestry of cryptic symbols and riddles, charting a course through perilous waters and uncharted territories. Isabela and Luis spent countless hours poring over the map, deciphering its clues. They realized that the journey would take them through the treacherous Devil's Triangle, across the uncharted isles of the Siren Sea, and into the heart of the Spanish Main. As they set sail aboard their ship, the midnight shadow, the crew's spirits were high, fueled by the promise of adventure and riches. The first leg of their journey took them through the Devil's Triangle, a region notorious for its supernatural occurrences and vanishing ships. The seas were rough, and the skies darkened as they navigated through the treacherous waters. During their passage, the crew faced their first trial, an encounter with a ghostly galleon that emerged from the fog, its crew long dead, but cursed to roam the seas. The spectral ship attacked, its cannons firing ethereal flames. Isabela and her crew fought bravely, repelling the ghostly assailants and navigating through the perilous waters. Luis's expertise in sea lore and navigation proved invaluable, guiding them safely through the otherworldly dangers of the Triangle. Escaping the Devil's Triangle, they set course for the Siren Sea, a stretch of water rumored to be haunted by sirens, whose songs lured sailors to their doom. Here, they faced their next challenge, resisting the enchanting melodies that threatened to lead them astray. Isabela, with her iron will, and Luis, with his knowledge of ancient chants, helped the crew stay focused, avoiding the deadly allure of the sirens. Their journey then took them to a hidden cove on an uncharted island, where the map revealed the entrance to an underground labyrinth. This labyrinth was a maze of tunnels and chambers, filled with traps and puzzles that tested their wit and resolve. The walls were lined with carvings that told the history of the Corsairs, Gold, and Serrano's adventures. As they navigated the labyrinth, they pieced together the story of Serrano's last voyage, a tale of betrayal and a cursed treasure. They learned that Serrano had hidden the Corsair's gold, not just to protect it, but also to guard a terrible secret it held. Finally, after overcoming the trials of the labyrinth, they emerged into a cavern where the treasure was said to be hidden. But instead of gold and jewels, they found only a lone chest, sealed with an intricate lock and bearing the symbol of the jaguar. Inside the chest, they discovered not treasure, but a collection of documents, maps, letters, and a journal belonging to Serrano. The journal revealed the shocking truth. The Corsair's gold was not a hoard of riches, but a collection of knowledge, maps of uncharted waters, strategies of naval warfare, and secrets of forgotten civilizations. The crew was initially disappointed, but Isabella and Luis recognized the true value of what they had found. The knowledge contained within those documents was more powerful than any treasure. It was the key to mastering the seas and uncovering lost worlds. As they sailed back to Tortuga, their ship laden not with gold, but with a treasure far greater, Isabella and her crew knew that their adventure had changed them. They had uncovered the mystery of the last Corsair and had gained knowledge that would make them legends in their own right. The quest for the Corsair's gold had been a journey of discovery, revealing that the true treasure was not in wealth, but in the adventure and the knowledge gained along the way. Captain Isabela Rivera and her crew had become part of a legend, their names forever etched in the annals of piracy and adventure. Chapter 2, A Map of Riddles. Captain Isabela Rivera and her first mate, Luis Martinez, along with their daring crew, sailed the Midnight Shadow through uncharted waters, their course dictated by the cryptic map that promised to lead them to the Corsair's gold. The map, an intricate puzzle in itself, was a labyrinth of symbols and hidden meanings that required all of Luis's expertise and Isabella's intuition to decipher. Their journey took them to mysterious islands, each holding a piece of the puzzle. The first was an island, enshrouded in perpetual fog, where the map led them to an ancient temple hidden within the dense jungle. Inside the temple, they faced their first riddle, a series of intricate puzzles and traps that tested their wits and agility. Solving these puzzles revealed a hidden chamber where they found a fragment of an ancient artifact inscribed with symbols that matched those on their map. This artifact was the key to unlocking the next phase of their quest. Continuing their voyage, the Midnight Shadow braved treacherous storms that threatened to tear the ship apart. Luis's skill as a navigator and Isabella's fearless leadership saw them through these trials, strengthening the bond between the crew as they faced adversity together. Their next destination was an island known to be the haunt of a fearsome pirate lord, a rival who had also been seeking the Corsair's gold. Isabella knew that confronting this pirate lord was inevitable. Upon landing, they were ambushed by the rival pirate crew, leading to a fierce battle on the shores. Isabela and her crew fought valiantly, their swords clashing against those of their enemies. The combat was intense, but the Midnight Shadow crew emerged victorious, capturing the pirate lord and gaining valuable information about another piece of the artifact. As they continued to follow the map, the riddles became more complex, leading them to explore underwater caves, navigate through mazes of coral reefs, and decipher ancient codes. Each location brought them closer to their goal, but also deeper into danger. The crew's loyalty and resolve were constantly tested as they encountered not only physical challenges, but also moral dilemmas. They came across a stranded group of sailors who had been victims of the same pirate lord they had defeated. Isabela, showing her compassionate side, decided to rescue them, knowing that it could delay their quest. This act of kindness proved fortuitous, as among the rescued sailors was an old sea dog who had once sailed with Rafael Serrano himself. The sailor provided invaluable insights into Serrano's final journey, bringing them one step closer to the Corsair's gold. The final riddle led them to a secluded cove, where the final piece of the artifact lay hidden. However, the cove was protected by a complex series of booby traps, a testament to Serrano's cunning and paranoia. Isabela, Luis, and their crew navigated these dangers with a combination of skill, bravery, and teamwork. After overcoming these final obstacles, they retrieved the last piece of the artifact. With the artifact complete, it revealed the true location of the Corsair's gold, not a physical treasure, but the location of a hidden library carved into the cliffs of a remote island. This library, created by Serrano himself, contained a wealth of knowledge, charts of hidden routes, secret naval tactics, and stories of forgotten lands. As they stood in the library, surrounded by centuries of knowledge, Captain Isabela and her crew realized the true nature of their quest. The Corsair's gold was not a treasure of gold and jewels, but a treasure of wisdom and adventure. A legacy left by Rafael Serrano for those daring enough to seek it. Their return to Tortuga was triumphant, not for the wealth they had acquired, but for the knowledge and stories they brought back. Captain Isabela and her crew had become part of the legend of the Corsair's Gold, their names whispered in taverns and sung in shanties, inspiring a new generation of pirates and adventurers. Chapter 3, Shadows of the Past. As Captain Isabela Rivera and her first mate, Luis Martinez, journeyed deeper into the heart of the uncharted seas, the enigma surrounding Rafael Serrano's disappearance began to unravel, revealing a narrative that intertwined their fate with the legendary Corsair. With the newfound knowledge from Serrano's hidden library, Isabela steered the Midnight Shadow towards a series of obscure locations that held clues to Serrano's past and the real reason behind his vanishing. Each location was a piece of the puzzle, shedding light on a larger and more complex conspiracy that involved not only pirates and corsairs, but also influential figures in the colonial empires. Their first stop was a secluded island known only to a few, where they discovered the ruins of what once was a thriving pirate haven. Here, in the debris of history, they found remnants of Serrano's life, personal belongings, that told a story of a man torn between his duty as a corsair and his personal code of honor. Among the relics, they found a series of letters between Serrano and an unknown correspondent, hinting at a powerful enemy who sought to control the seas for their gain. Isabella and Luis realized that their quest for the Corsair's gold had unknowingly led them into a dangerous game of power and betrayal. Serrano's disappearance was not a simple matter of a lost pirate. It was a calculated move in a chess game for control of the seas. Their journey took them next to a colonial port, where they went undercover to gather information. They learned of a clandestine society that operated in the shadows, manipulating trade routes and political alliances. This society had seen Serrano as a threat, a rogue element that could disrupt their plans. Serrano's quest for the Corsair's gold, it seemed, was his way of undermining this society's grip on the seas. The revelation hit the crew hard. They were no longer just treasure hunters. They were now players in a dangerous game that spanned empires and oceans. Their every move was watched, and their every step was fraught with peril. Isabella and Luis, along with their loyal crew, faced numerous challenges as they continued their quest. They encountered traps laid by the shadowy society, faced betrayal from within, and navigated complex political waters where alliances were as shifting as the tides. In one of their most daring exploits, they infiltrated a gala on a governor's estate, where they uncovered crucial information about the society's next move, a plan to seize a strategic port that would give them unchallenged power over the sea roads. Isabella and her crew devised a bold plan to thwart this move, putting their skills and their lives on the line. The plan led to a night of intense action, where sword clashed against sword under the cover of darkness. The Midnight Shadow crew fought bravely, outsmarting and outmaneuvering their adversaries. Their success that night struck a significant blow to the society's plans and marked them as formidable foes. As they pieced together more of Serrano's past and the society's intentions, Isabella and Luis realized that the real treasure Serrano had been seeking was not gold, but freedom, the freedom of the seas from tyranny and control. Serrano had hidden the Corsair's gold, not as a hoard of wealth, but as a symbol of this freedom. The final piece of the puzzle led them to a remote island where Serrano was last seen. The island, shrouded in mist and mystery, held the key to the entire saga. As they explored the island, they came upon a hidden cove where the remnants of Serrano's ship lay. Here, they faced their final challenge. The society, having followed them, launched a full-scale attack, intent on eliminating them and erasing all traces of Serrano's legacy. A fierce battle ensued on the shores and in the waters of the cove. Isabella and Luis fought side by side with their crew, their resolve unshaken. In the heat of the battle, Isabella and Luis discovered the ultimate truth. Serrano had faked his death to protect his crew and his treasure. He had outwitted the society, leaving behind clues that only a true corsair could follow. Serrano had hoped that one day, someone would continue his quest for freedom. With the society's forces defeated and their plans foiled, Isabella and her crew emerged victorious. They honored Serrano's legacy by vowing to continue his fight for the freedom of the seas. The Corsair's gold, now in their possession, was more than a treasure. It was a beacon of hope for all free-spirited sailors who roamed the ocean. As they set sail from the island, the Midnight Shadow crew knew that their journey had changed them. They had started as treasure hunters, but had become guardians of a legacy. Their adventures had revealed the true meaning of being a corsair. It was not just about plunder and fame. It was about courage, freedom, and the unyielding spirit of the sea. Chapter 4: The Corsair's Legacy. Captain Isabela Rivera, Luis Martinez, and the valiant crew of the Midnight Shadow stood on the deck of their ship, the sea breeze mixing with the exhilarating sense of triumph and discovery. They had successfully unraveled the mystery of Rafael Serrano's disappearance and foiled the plans of the secretive society that sought to control the seas. But their adventure was far from over. With the Corsair's gold in their possession, they now held a treasure trove of ancient maritime knowledge and maps to uncharted territories. This information made them the target of various factions vying for power over the seas. Isabela knew that to honor Serrano's legacy, they must use the Corsair's gold wisely to preserve the freedom of the seas and protect those who navigate its waters. The crew agreed to continue their mission, becoming custodians of the knowledge and defenders against those who would use it for domination. Their journey took them to the corners of the known world, where they used the Corsair's gold to outmaneuver navies and rival pirates. They liberated oppressed ports, disrupted the trade routes of the oppressive society, and shared their knowledge with other free-spirited sailors. As their legend grew, so did the challenges they faced. The shadowy society, enraged by their defeat, launched a relentless pursuit of the Midnight Shadow. In response, Isabela and her crew honed their skills, becoming adept at evading capture and engaging in naval battles. One of their most significant challenges came when they sailed into the treacherous waters of the Bermuda Triangle, seeking a hidden island that Serrano had marked as significant. There, they encountered not only natural dangers, but also a trap set by the society. A fierce naval battle ensued, with the Midnight Shadow pitted against a fleet of warships. In the heat of battle, Isabela and Luis demonstrated exceptional leadership and bravery. They maneuvered their ship through the deadly waters, using the triangle's mysterious properties to their advantage. The battle culminated in a daring maneuver that saw them escape through a narrow channel, barely wide enough for their ship. Having escaped the society's clutches, Isabela steered the Midnight Shadow towards their next destination, a secret meeting of free captains. This conclave, held on a secluded island, was a gathering of the most formidable pirates and privateers of the age. There, Isabela and Luis shared their discoveries and formed alliances, solidifying a network of resistance against the society and other oppressive forces. These alliances proved crucial in the months that followed. The Midnight Shadow and its allies waged a campaign of disruption against the society, liberating seized cargoes, raiding their outposts, and spreading the ideals of freedom and resistance across the seas. But the true test of their resolve came when the society launched a final, desperate attack against the pirate stronghold of Nassau, a free port and haven for many who lived by the pirate's code. Isabela, Luis, and their allies rallied to defend the port, leading a coalition of pirate ships against the society's formidable armada. The battle for Nassau was epic, a clash of cannons and wills that raged for days. The Midnight Shadow sailed at the forefront, cutting through enemy lines with Isabella at the helm, and Luis commanding the guns. The pirates fought with the ferocity of those defending their home and freedom. As the smoke cleared, the Society's fleet lay in ruins, their plans to control the seas shattered. The victory at Nassau was celebrated across the pirate world, a testament to the power of unity and the enduring spirit of the Corsairs. In the aftermath of the battle, Isabella and her crew continued to roam the seas, now revered as guardians of freedom and champions of the pirate way. The Corsair's gold remained in their safekeeping, a symbol of their commitment to protecting the secrets and treasures of the seas. Captain Isabella Rivera and Luis Martinez had started their journey in search of treasure, but found something far more valuable, a purpose and a legacy. They had become more than pirates. They were legends, their names whispered in awe in taverns and ports across the world. Their adventures became tales told by sailors for generations, inspiring others to seek freedom and adventure on the high seas. The Midnight Shadow sailed into history, her crew forever remembered as the last Corsairs, the defenders of the untamed ocean, and the keepers of its most ancient and sacred secrets.